Interview commenced at 9:42 a.m. What's your full name and address?
Kevin Donald Witherspoon, 5 Brushy Creek Road, Gangan.
State your age and date of birth.
17. 18th of the 12th, 1982.
I intend to interview you in relation to the murder of Glenys Lund at Gangan 3 days ago on the 12th of February. Before continuing, I must inform you that you are not obliged to say or do anything, but anything you say or do may be given in evidence. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Kevin, this is serious. It doesn't get any more serious than this. Do you understand what is happening?
I understand.
You have the following rights. You may communicate with a friend or relative to inform that person of your whereabouts. You may communicate with a legal practitioner. Do you understand?
Yes.
You wish to exercise these rights before I begin the questioning?
There's no point. I killed her. I murdered her. I killed Glenys Lund.
Well, let's just take it step by step.
I'm telling you, I killed her. And I killed the others. I killed all of them.
Motor vehicle accident on the old Gangan Leighton Road. Bus and station wagon. Can you check the Leighton Hospital standing by?
Copy that, Gary. All available medical staff are being called in now.
Thanks, over. Oh, Lord. Be with all who are facing death today in fear and loneliness. Bless and uphold all those who are in sickness and pain. Amen.
Come in, give me a hand, where I can't move.
Kevin, help me, will you?
Buddy, wait your turn. Here, Laura, I've got you. I've got you. I've got you.
Glenys, can you hear me? Glenys!
I'm going to get help.
Just hold it there, hold it there.
It's okay. Oh my God. Anyone else inside?
Leave us inside.
Leave us here. Get everyone down here and hurry. Babe, Kevin, it's okay.
There's people still inside the bus. Help the people in the bus. Kevin's in the bus. Get the people out of the bus. There's people in the bus.
You've done enough.
You're a hero, mate.
Get on to Benalla Memorial. We'll take whoever they've got.
Gary. My daughter, Jane.
Sorry to drag you out of bed.
How's Jane, Mark?
Oh, she's doing okay, considering. And two of the kids are dead. Lucy and Graham. Heaven as well.
Oh, God.
He was the driver of the bus.
Poor Julie.
Liam's being just rushed into emergency surgery. I mean, the rest of the kids are sort of, they're just suffering minor injuries, you know, apart from being stressed and buggery.
Jane's done trauma counselling. If I can help.
I mean, this place just isn't geared to cope with a bus smash.
Jane did a regular medical degree before she went into shrinking.
Uh-huh. I'll be appreciated.
Coming through.
Accident investigation on a blood sample taken from Glenys Lund. She was the driver of the wagon. Looks like the car just swerved off the road, it bounced off some rocks and
Jim.
Smashed.
Sweetie, you're meant to be lying down.
Jim, my darling, we bad people. Is God punishing us?
Oh, sweetie.
Could have happened to anyone, anywhere, anytime.
I had a stink of petrol. I was trying to wash my hands, but I couldn't get it off.
Oh, sweetie. Come on.
Can you smell it?
Yeah.
Come on, we'll get you some clean clothes.
Come on. Oh, Jim. There's blood. Why is there blood?
It could be internal. Could you get us a little x-ray first?
Gemma. Gemma, come on. Come on.
I'll get a mop.
Do you know where you are, Glenys? Your fingers.
How you doing, Gwen?
Well, you got tricky bangs. You've been told that before. Glenys, do you know why you're here? How you got here? Do you remember the accident at all? Do you know if you bumped your head?
She's Angela's daughter, Glenn. You're on holiday. What's wrong with her?
Well, if she hit her head on impact, she may have a small bleed pressing on her brain. She'll need a CT scan. Can you rotate it for me, please?
Annabelle, try and move your foot.
Or try flexing it.
You have to listen to the doctor, right?
Annabelle, I don't think it's broken. It's probably only sprained. Can you move it at all?
I'm cold.
Could you get a blanket?
Kevin.
Thanks. Annabelle, everything's fine. You're safe now. I want you to do something for me. Can you look at me? Come on. I want you to look at me. Look at me. Come on. Look at me. That's fine. Okay, now calm down. Try breathing. Breathe in. And out. In. And out. That's it.
What are we doing here? What's going on?
Don't you remember? We were heading home from the theatre festival in Ballarat.
And you're putting on a play, weren't you?
In the summer of the 17th doll, she got an honourable mention.
Host, Baba.
And do you remember anything of the journey home?
Well, we were singing.
And what were you singing?
You'll never get to heaven. We'll never get to heaven. In Aaron's van. In Aaron's van. Cause Aaron's van. He's an old tin can. Oh, Kevin, he's trapped. Dad, oh, God, oh, Dad.
Help me, Annabelle.
I can't reach you.
Annabelle, help me.
Dad, I can't.
Leave me.
No!
He was already dead.
He was alive! Oh, he was alive!
No, he wasn't. There was nothing he could do.
Why? You made me leave him!
I had to.
I
had to.
Sweetie, Dad's neck was broken.
Oh, no! Oh, no!
He's been gone, Annabelle. God's looking after him.
Oh, Dad! Oh.
Oh.
How do you cope? I'm completely run out.
You know, I've never seen this side of you before.
I never attended a bus crash before.
We'll just have to pray and hope.
Boy in surgery. Liam Fellows. They had to remove his spleen.
Is that the parents?
They lost their daughter earlier tonight.
What does that mean, remove your spleen? Is it bad?
Kevin has lost a lot of blood. They're having difficulty keeping him stable.
He's going to be okay.
Oh, he's young, he's healthy.
Lord, there are times in life when everything seems to press against us. When one problem goes, another one quickly replaces it. When our low periods seem to have no end and our good times no beginning. When we feel all alone. Lord, you promised to be a leader and guide us out of the darkness. Help us to pray, Lord. Help us to pray, Lord. Amen.
White tea, all right?
Oh, that's wonderful, thanks.
I'm Alicia.
I'm Jane. Someone had a look at you, Alicia?
Yeah, one of the nurses. She said it probably won't scar.
I doubt it. How are you coping otherwise?
Okay, I guess. I just keep thinking about the accident. Yeah. If it wasn't for Kevin.
To your boyfriend?
He got us all out. And I kind of thought that was it, you know, that we were safe. And then the car went up and he went back for Glenys. And every time I shut my eyes, he's in there with her and he can't get out. You know.
Get your hands off me!
What's wrong with you two?
Well, tough guy now, aren't you?
They probably took it off because of all the tubes and stuff.
Can you find a pin or something?
Necessary. I really have to get home. My cats will be frantic.
How many fingers?
Three.
Do you know where you are?
Leighton Hospital. I know there's been a terrible accident, but I don't remember it.
You don't remember Kevin pulling you out of the car? Can you touch your nose for me, please?
It wasn't anyone.
You killed my Evan. I don't remember.
Doctor says she's got a small tear in her esophagus. That's why she swallowed the blood. I reckon it should heal by itself, but they want to keep her in there just to be sure.
Well, that's good news.
Yeah.
Glenys's CT scan. It's absolutely clear. No sign of neurological injury whatsoever.
All good news.
I saw her at 11 o'clock last night. Slurred speech, sluggish pupils, her motor skills were really poor.
That's classic signs of neurological damage. 5 a.m. this morning, everything's back to normal. Now, that's way too fast for a brain injury to heal.
What are you saying?
Well, there are some medications that might explain it.
Medications? What are you talking about?
Tranquilizers, sedatives, barbiturates. The effects are relatively short-lived.
Gary,
Glynis, are you taking drugs?
Drugs? What?
Are you on some bloody medication, you know, tranquilizers or something?
What are you talking about?
It's a simple question, Glynis. Did you take any drugs last night?
I don't take that stuff. You know that, Gary. I didn't take anything.
Well, I hope to God you didn't, because we've just lost 3 of our best and brightest. Hope to God you didn't.
Coming up to this turn off.
Hitting the rocks?
No.
Which means you blacked out before the impact. You lost control because you blacked out, then it's not the other way around.
I didn't take anything.
What if the drug test comes back positive?
It won't. I don't know. I can't believe they've gone. Thanks for the lift.
Are you sure you don't want me to come in for a while?
No. Cats have been locked in all night. It's not going to be pretty.
Well, I'll be at Mum's if you change your mind.
Sonny, Jim, not your speed at all.
I'll scramble you some eggs.
Oh, no, it's all right. I'm going to juice these.
For breakfast?
I'm getting fit.
Spare me. Here. Gary mentioned you're having Glynis drug tested.
Oh, did he?
This is a woman who's trying to organise an organic food co-op.
Do you know from the church?
And from the village, yeah.
What's she like?
Nice enough. I don't know her all that well, really. She's not the kind of woman who relates to other women. At least not when there are men around. Ooh. You're certain about the drugs? Because if you're wrong...
Notice you're not wearing a fish.
I haven't lost my grip, Jane. I just go along singing when I'm in the mood.
When you're in the mood to see your policeman friend.
Do I need to peel these?
No, just rinse them. That's why you invited me up here, isn't it?
give him the tick of approval. I invited you up here because you're my only offspring and I haven't seen you in an age. Sonny Jim, out, you wicked wretched animal. Outside. Sorry, dear. Just the door's water.
Mum, having a shower? Something I prefer to do in private?
We are seeing each other, in point of fact, Gary and I.
Is that a euphemism for going at it like rabbits?
There's no need to be crude. What do you think of him?
Well, apart from the fact that he's young enough to be my brother, seems to be quite sound, good teeth, clear eyes, no obvious signs of madness. Never let me have a dog.
Like you could do with a blast.
No thanks, I'm trying to spring clean my liver. Toivo, isn't it?
It's not bad shit. Grow it ourselves.
Shouldn't you be at home resting?
Been resting all my life.
You've just been through a major trauma. You're probably still in shock.
Only medication I need's the self-administered kind.
I read the tribute you left at the roadside. The only truly dead are those who have been forgotten. It's a beautiful sentiment.
It's just some Jewish proverb I ripped off. Tried to write something of my own, from the heart, but I guess I don't feel anything. Wonder what it's like. Crossing the Styx. River of death. You ever wonder that? There are five rivers separating living and the dead. There's woe, lamentation, fire, forgetfulness, and death.
No, I think the fifth one's hate, not death.
It doesn't matter. Wrong people always die anyway.
Yeah, it's natural to blame yourself when something like this happens. It's nobody's fault.
You're a shrink, aren't you?
Isn't that obvious?
To the experienced observer?
You do a lot of drugs, Toivo?
Not nearly enough, Doc. Not nearly enough.
To death.
I offered to go inside with her, but she said she was okay.
No other cars at the house. This sort of thing doesn't happen here. Just doesn't.
Was she sexually assaulted?
We're still waiting for the pathologist, but doesn't look like it.
A local, you think?
Probably some passing stray. Pulls off the highway for whatever reason. She's out getting some air. She wanders into his path.
Well, what about the drug test obviously got around? People were talking about it.
Well, there's no such thing as confidentiality in a country town. You should bloody well know that. Sorry, lack of sleep. What the hell was she doing down there?
You should have been at home, sleeping it off with the mangy cats.
Let's just leave it to homicide, shall we? Ned Kelly?
He finally caught the little bugger. Use him for doing community work. Take him round to the schools and he gives them the dirt on the life of crime. That counselling office still open?
Sure.
Good. Because I think we're going to need it.
I could do with a bit of counselling too, sweetie.
Everyone in the community is affected in some way when something like this happens.
You might be feeling anger, confusion, guilt. You could be having trouble sleeping.
It might be that you keep playing things over and over in your mind, going through the what-ifs, the if-onlys. If you'd like to share your thoughts and feelings, please call. Hi, who am I speaking to?
I just heard Linus Lund has been murdered. Is that true?
At this stage, we don't really know what's happened.
She seemed such a jolly, outgoing girl. I don't understand what's going on in this town. It's enough to make a body question her faith in God.
I understand your anguish. I'm sure there are many people who feel the same way.
Jane, may I butt in here?
I believe it's times like this when our faith is most important to us.
Thanks, Rosemary. Hi, you're on the air. Who's this?
I just wanted to say I think she deserved it.
Sorry, I'm not sure what you mean.
Glenys Lund, I think she had it coming. I don't want anyone feeling sorry for her. Just save it for Lucy and Graham and Evan. That's all.
Emotions run very high at times like this. We don't always mean what we say. Nevertheless, it's important that we do say it.
Hello. Am I on the air?
Yeah, this is Jane.
Leo Burrs.
Janie, how are you?
You've put on a couple of kilos.
Yeah, it's good to see you as well. Jane Halifax, this is Simon Fink.
You saw a boy called Toivo Carlson about 10 minutes before you arrived here. Is that right, Janie?
Jane. Yeah, we had a brief conversation. He gave no indication that he'd seen Glenys Lund, though.
And how far was this from the murder scene?
About a kilometre.
Well, it took you 10 minutes to run a kilometre. You weren't pushing yourself.
Simon runs for the Mooney Ponds Harriers.
Oh, I used to.
I'm overwhelmed.
Seeing as how you're here, Janie, what about joining the team? Locals are a bit shaky after last night, and they did respond well to your soothing tones on the airwaves this morning.
We heard the last few minutes on the way in. I thought you were very, very good.
A bit light on for laughs, I thought. I need your help, Janie.
Sure.
Good. Let's go and sniff out a carcass, shall we? Really did a job on her, whoever he was.
Oh, we use he in the contractual sense. Words importing one gender shall include the other.
Tell me about Glenys Lund.
Well, she was one of the drivers in last night's crash. Rented cottage up on the hill, just her and her cats, English and drama teacher at Leighton High, and the leader of the church theatre group.
Her pendant's missing. Her fish pendant, chatted on at the hospital.
On payback, you reckon? Someone lured her down here to punish her for causing the crash?
Smells like someone local to me.
Well, hang on. You know I'm local. Now, if I wanted to kill her, I'd have done it at her place. I mean, this is way too public for me.
It mightn't have been planned. She comes down here, gets into an argument with someone, grabs the nearest rock. Weapon of opportunity.
What do you think of Glenys Lund?
Some days I liked her, some days I didn't.
What do you think about someone murdering her?
Saved me the trouble.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know what I mean. Sometimes I open my mouth and stuff just comes out.
Did you murder Glenys Lund?
No.
What were you doing down the river?
Always go to the river. I like to watch the water.
You see anybody else in your travels?
Charon.
Charon? Who the hell is Charon?
The ferryman. He takes you across the River Styx.
Are you stoned, Mr. Carlson?
If you'd ever seen me stoned, you wouldn't ask.
So what we do next is find a suspect from the planet Earth.
Told me the wrong people always die.
You never mentioned that before.
Well, I took it as survivor guilt. Now I'm not sure what it was.
Well, Janey, you're either on my team or you're in my team. What is it?
Well, going on the crime scene evidence, we're looking for the classic disorganized spontaneous killer. Frenzied nature of the attack, use of the nearest rock as a murder weapon, obliteration of facial features, lack of any attempt to hide the body.
Except there's no sexual assault.
So what have we got? A revenge kill that looks like a thrill kill.
It's one thing to point the finger and gossip, bashing a skull in.
He sleeps.
People kill each other all the time. I mean, they don't like your hairdo. Boom. This woman was responsible for 3 deaths. Where are you going? You don't want a potato cake? They're beautiful.
Oh, you're going to be dead before you're 50, Leo. Bye, Simon. See you, Gary.
Leo? Mm-hmm. The two of you didn't ever...
Me and Joe?
Yeah. Really?
No. Women have appetite, Simon, but they very rarely extend to coppers with bad dress sense.
There's something you should know about Glenys. She liked indoor sports.
You mean she slept around, Gary?
You didn't hear it from me.
No, but we saw your lips move.
Hi.
Hi.
This is Sandy and Claire.
Hi. Hi. Since you're here, can you tell me where Annabelle lives?
She's staying with us. Her mum's not in a very good way. They had to sedate her and stuff.
Right.
I'll show you if you want.
Great.
Excellent car.
Thanks.
It suits you.
Thanks.
One for Lucy. One for Graham. One for Dad. We made our debut last month. Me and Annie and Gemma and Lucy and Claire, a whole heap of us. That's Evan. I'm sorry you didn't meet him. He was a wonderful man. At church, he used to tell us the most inspirational stories.
He looks lovely.
His suit, it was too tight. He was too vain to let it out. Why does God let good people die?
Alicia, could you make us a cup of tea?
Thanks.
Annabelle, someone phoned into the radio station this afternoon. She didn't leave her name, she was disguising her voice. Was it you?
What if I did?
I'm not accusing you of anything. I just want you to try and understand your feelings.
Glenys was full of dope. She caused the crash. She killed my dad.
We don't know that for sure. And even if she was using drugs, surely you don't think she caused the crash intentionally.
You don't understand. That bitch deserved to die. It was God's justice.
Christ behind me, Christ in me, Christ below me, Christ above me, Christ to my left, Christ to my right, Christ where I sit, Christ where I lie, Christ where I rise. Christ be with me, Christ be in me, Christ in front of me, Christ beside me, Christ where I sit, Christ where I lie, Christ my left, Christ to my right.
Don't do that!
didn't happen like that, Gemma.
Yes, it did.
Gemma, darling, listen to Jane. She knows how the imagination works.
Gemma, you've been through a really traumatic event. You're probably experiencing a post-traumatic stress reaction. It's not uncommon.
I didn't imagine it. Someone lit a match and chucked it in the petrol.
Or did you see this person? Did you recognise them?
It was too dark.
Look, I'm sure you saw something. But sometimes we can only remember snippets of what's actually happened. We have to work really hard to join the dots. The best advice I can give is to go back to before the accident and work through it step by step.
Sweetie, look at it from a different angle. I mean, no one would deliberately set fire to Glenys' car. I mean, it doesn't make sense.
I know. But somebody wanted Glenys to burn.
Close your ears, Sonny Jim. Kevin, it's nearly midnight.
Are you going to bed?
Well, that's why I'm wearing pyjamas, yes. You all right?
I can't sleep. I was wondering if you could give me something.
Come in. Old-fashioned, but it works.
Haven't you got pills or something?
Why don't you try the milk first? Any news about Liam?
No change. Still in the coma. Doctors say he might never come out. Is that right?
It's possible. But it's just as possible he'll be okay too. I know how you must feel. There's nothing you can do to help, and you'd do anything if you could.
I'm not even the right blood group.
Glenys' death can't be making things any easier.
And the girls reckon it was some sort of psycho. They're talking about arming themselves in case he strikes again. Nobody really knows anybody else, do they? What they're capable of.
We're just as capable of the greatest kindnesses too. Don't forget that.
You had a visitor last night.
Hmm. So did you.
If you ate properly, you wouldn't have to put yourself through that purgatory.
Well, I'm hoping to live to a ripe old age, like you.
So, who was he, this friend of yours? Don't make me beg.
Kevin Witherspoon. Oh, please. What do you think of young Kevin?
Seems too good to be true. Mind you, they breed them that way in this valley.
I think we're becoming friends.
Well, that'll make a nice change for you.
Lady Chatterley's lover.
He's beautiful. Be honest. What?
The AIS reckon the fuel ignited here.
Did they say how?
Well, you know, metal to metal, hot engine sparks.
From way up there?
Yeah. Digital phone could have triggered it.
How unlucky can you get? Saved from a fiery furnace one day and murdered the next.
My daughter thinks she saw someone throw a match into the fuel.
Well, geez, you might have phoned that in, old son. Feel up to answering a couple of questions? Now, Gemma, your dad tells us that you noticed something unusual immediately after the accident. Is that right?
You mean like someone lighting match?
Hmm. Do you want to tell us about that?
It was just my imagination.
Oh, sorry, I didn't see anything. Really.
So you're saying that you didn't see anyone throw a match?
Well, it's just like Dr. Halifax said. It was just a hallucination on account of my post-traumatic stress reaction.
Hello, Dr. Halifax.
Annabelle, can you describe your feelings towards Glenys Lund? You had any reason to dislike her? Any reason at all?
No, I liked her. I thought she was okay.
So you don't blame her for causing the accident?
No.
Didn't the accident cost the life of your dad?
That wasn't her fault.
Well, did you tell Dr. Halifax that Glenys Lund deserved to die?
She said that?
Did you or didn't you say that?
Oh, I don't feel well, Mrs. Pock.
Did you or didn't you say that?
No. Stop badgering the girl. She's answered the question.
Mrs. Pock, please. Annabelle, could you tell me your movements yesterday from the time that you left the hospital?
You're treating her like a criminal.
Mrs. Pock.
I'm here to protect her interests, and that's what I intend to do.
Annabelle, please. Just tell us what you did yesterday.
Mrs. Halifax dropped us home and I put Mum to bed and Mrs. Pock came by later. And I don't know what time.
And what did you do while your Mum slept?
I tried to sleep too.
Satisfied? That's enough. You run it on.
Interview concluded at 10:08. Would you mind confirming the time, Mrs. Pock?
Just grieving for a dead father. Are you completely insensitive to that?
Would you mind confirming the time, Mrs. Polk?
Well, the females don't like Glenys Lund. That's pretty obvious. Still, it's common enough in a pride, attacking the unattached lioness.
I'd say little Annabelle could rip somebody to bits. Oh, look, the kid can hardly walk. How's she going to attack anyone?
Took her by surprise.
Crept up behind her at the waterhole.
Wow!
You two are bloody ghouls, Ben Dinkum. I mean, these are good people. Murderers in Queensland by now.
Gary, what was done to Glenys's face? Doesn't fit a stranger. You destroy someone's face because that represents who they are.
Ergo, we look closer to home.
Why don't you take five, dear?
Yeah. Fine.
Digger Junior, Gemma, she changed her mind, didn't she?
Someone got to her.
Wonder who?
Evan was a nuts and bolts kind of guy. Like, he made everything happen. He built the sets and did the lighting and everything. Glenys was like the creative spark. They're a great team.
Alicia, thanks for that. Interview concluded at 4:13. Would you like me to get you a drink or something?
I'd run a marathon barefoot over broken glass for her.
You just get your feet cut, my friend.
Hey, has Glenys's drag screen got back yet?
Oh, we asked for it to be fast-tracked. We'll probably get him back in time for the Olympics.
Thing.
What if someone deliberately fed Glenys drugs?
Flipped her a Mickey.
I checked with the pharmacist. She's not on computer records as being a prescription sedative user.
That bastard told me I'd need a warrant.
Doesn't mean she didn't use them.
No, at the hospital she was adamant she didn't use drugs.
Could mean that accident was no accident.
But a first attempt on her life.
What's that? Sounds like someone's dying.
It's a gang cockatoo. It's watching for danger while the rest of the flock eats. Okay, let's just assume for the moment that someone did actually persuade Gemma to change her mind about the match.
I'd say the Mickey Finn was a first attempt, and the match throwing could have been a second go.
The match thrower might be the same person who pulped Glenys' skull with a chunk of quartz.
Third time lucky.
Which makes him one of the theatre kids, right?
And what's the motive? Did she give him a bad review? Our God-fearing friend Gary doesn't exactly believe in the monkish life, does he? We gather he made a pilgrimage to Glenys's bed.
Do you fancy a quick 5K run before dinner, Janie?
With you?
Why do plain clothes policemen wear such plain clothes?
I think it's got something to do with their salaries.
You're not planning to get involved with either of them, are you?
Can you think of anyone who might have had a quiet word in Gemma's ear?
You think it was Gary, don't you? You must spend every waking hour looking for the worst in people. I find it very sad.
Aren't you a part of this, Toivo?
They look like a bunch of crows.
A murder of crows. It's a collective noun. Come on.
We give back to you, O God, those you gave to us. You didn't lose them when you gave them to us, and we didn't lose them by their return to you. Your dear Son taught us that life is eternal and love, it cannot die. Farewell and safe journey, Evan. Farewell and safe journey, Lucy. Farewell and safe journey, Graham.
Farewell and safe journey, Graham.
Farewell and safe journey, Glynis. Farewell and safe journey, Glynis.
Farewell and safe journey, Glynis.
Sorry. It was a very moving service. Doesn't bring my father back, though, does it? Gemma. Any further post-traumatic hallucinations?
No, thanks.
I was just wondering if maybe you'd mentioned it to someone else.
Just trying to forget about it. Doesn't she sing like an absolute angel? She breaks my heart. Excuse me. Thank you for being here today, Jane. Could you come to dinner tonight? Annabelle will be there and I've asked Gemma to join us. The girls need a guiding hand just now.
Oh, yeah, of course. Sure. Would you excuse me? Mm.
Got to get back to the hospital.
Sorry for interrupting.
He's very upset.
Will.
Alicia, I need to ask you something, and I'm relying on your discretion. How would you describe the relationship between Glenys and Annabelle's dad?
You mean, were they lovers?
How did you know that?
How did you?
I saw them together at the motel we were staying at in Ballarat.
At the theatre festival?
Mm. They're in the bar and he was crying and she was kissing his fingers.
Are you prepared to tell the police that?
I can't. I promised Annabelle. You can't pass this on, Jane. She'd kill me.
Music, dancing, equestrian, I'm impressed.
I bet you were a high achiever.
Oh, you should have seen her. Whenever we had guests over, she'd suddenly appear in costume and now she had a song for us. Of course, if you didn't give her your undivided attention, there'd be hell to pay.
Excuse me.
What are you trying to do to us?
What?
We said goodbye to my father today, and now you're going around spreading malicious gossip about him.
Annabelle, I'm sorry. There's been a murder. I'm... Wine, Jane?
Yes, please. Thanks.
Would you like to say grace for us, please, Jane?
Sure. For what we're about to receive, may the Lord make us truly thankful. And we remember in this troubled time those who are seriously ill, Liam and Laura. Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly.
The Virgin Mary. Didn't know the Gangang Church was Catholic. It's not, but don't you think she was an admirable human being? I'm sorry about Annabelle. I felt like I had to tell her.
Oh, that's fine. She's your friend. I understand the loyalty.
I don't normally allow people in here.
No, I'm flattered.
I like you. Tell me, did you like Glenys? I kind of felt sorry for her.
Why?
I think she was a really unhappy person. Lonely, you know? Mm. Lonely, desperate, and middle-aged.
Middle-aged? She's younger than me.
You got me more than 25, 26 tops.
Thank you. How long have you and Kevin been going out?
13 months. He gave me this on our anniversary.
Oh, that's pretty.
He's going to exchange it for a proper engagement ring when he starts making money.
Really?
Don't tell anyone, though, please. It's our secret, okay?
Okay.
see. What's he listening to?
Just screaming jets.
Hmm?
We're learning to play a couple of their songs. Me, Graham and Liam.
Oh, I like the screaming jets. When I'm in the mood.
My mum reckons they ought to be castrated.
What's your band called?
Spina Bifida.
Oh. Well, that's memorable. Tasteless, but memorable.
Thanks for coming to see me. I think that on some level he knows we're here. Do you believe that?
Yeah, I do. But you can't stay here all night, Kevin. Come on, I'll take you home. Save you the rubber on your shoes.
I'm okay.
You should see the circles under your eyes.
Oh.
I'll get a doctor. It's a good sign.
Hey, how are you, mate? Hey. Of your heart. Near, hold me. Refine, purge, set me on fire. Raise me aloft until my own self knows utter annihilation. I'm not inviting you in, but Mum's probably got one of her migraines.
Kevin. If there's anything you want to get off your chest.
Like what?
Oh, I don't know. Anything that might be bothering you?
No, nothing's bothering me. I'm fine. Liam's going to be okay. Yeah.
Well, I can't deprive you of your favourite jet CD.
And take it. Dave Gleason's sat on the front there.
Who's Dave Gleason?
Obviously don't know them well. He's their front man.
Well, thanks. I'll treasure it.
Thanks.
Told you.
Is a rabbit on Viagra.
Put a finger on me and I call the police.
Yeah, well, the glove comes off tonight.
Oh. Glass of wine, dear? Why not?
Why the glum face, Dr. Halifax?
The kids know something. It's like there's some sort of conspiracy not to talk.
Well, don't tell me that the celebrated forensic psychiatrist is baffled by a bunch of teenagers.
You don't think you might be losing your perspective, dear?
How do you mean?
Well, Gary knows them better than you do. He's watched them all grow up.
Yeah, but I ask questions, make observations and draw conclusions. That's my discipline.
Jane, your detective mates are hung up on the kids. I mean, they can't see anything else.
Because that's where all the signs are pointing, Gary.
It's tunnel vision. I mean, what about Glenys's family? What about the deadbeats in her past? What about her workmates? I mean, how about we cast an eye over them before we start condemning a bunch of innocent kids?
Look, I realise you're sensitive about Gemma's involvement, but...
I'm not talking about Gemma. I'm talking about basic police procedures.
Gary, with enormous respect, you're not in possession of all the facts. You don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, I'm just some dumb as dirt country cop, wouldn't know his elbow from his arse, whereas you're some bloody, Oh, what's that word?
Dilettante.
Dilettante.
Oh, for God's sake, you haven't been involved in all the briefings.
Well, I didn't have a choice in it, did I?
Gary, you're too close to these people. You're too compromised.
Well, knowing someone isn't compromise in my book.
Well, I'm sorry, but sleeping with a murder victim is in mine. I'm sorry, that was totally uncalled for.
I think I'd better be going. I'll call you in the morning.
Gary, don't go on,
James. No, it's all right. My fault picking a fight. don't even know what a dilettante is.
Mum, I didn't mean it. I just pulled it out of the air. I'm
well aware who you were aiming at. You always were a spiteful child.
Mum, have you got Carol Witherspoon's phone number?
Witherspoon? No, why?
It doesn't matter. I've got to get on to Gary. Cameron is Dr. Halifax.
Carol! Gary Preston! Get in, Carol!
What's up?
Carol, where's Kevin?
Asleep.
Where's his bedroom?
The second door on the right. What's going on,
this
Gary?
One.
Yeah.
Kevin.
What?
Kevin.
What's going on?
Wake up, Kevin. Kevin.
Done?
Wake up.
Kevin.
Kevin.
What's happened? What the? What's he done? Kevin. Kevin. Kevin, wake up. Kevin, what's he done? What's he done? Kevin, wake up.
Memo to Senior Constable Gary Preston. I'm writing to apologise for all the trouble I've caused. I'm responsible for all the bad things that have happened.
It was me who killed Glenys Lund. And it was me who caused the crash. I didn't mean to kill Graham, Lucy and Evan. I was trying to kill Glenys and I failed. When the station wagon caught fire, I just pulled her out without thinking. Anyhow, now I've finished the job. I'm not asking for forgiveness. It's between me and God. Yours, Kevin D. Witherspoon.
He came to me asking for sleeping tablets.
The pills were his grandma's supply. She's a hoarder.
Benzodiazepines. The same stuff Glenys had in the bloodstream.
He doesn't claim responsibility for setting the station wagon on fire.
Maybe Gemma imagined it, like she said.
You sure it
can? Yeah, it was emailed from his computer.
That doesn't necessarily mean he sent it.
Must remember to ask him that when he wakes up. We did find a pair of bloodstained jeans in his wardrobe.
I'm hanging out to hear his motive.
Yeah.
I should have picked up on this.
What, that he's a four-time killer?
That he was suicidal.
If it wasn't for you, he'd be dead right now.
We tried to build ourselves a healthy community. A safe haven for our kids. No bullshit. No fancy trappings. Just a commitment to try and live by Christ's teachings. Well, it didn't bloody work, did it?
Why don't we reserve judgment until we get the full picture? Okay?
Seems like such a sweet young man. Mind you, that's what they say about the boys in the United States, the ones in the Bible Belt, the ones who massacre their classmates. Would you categorize Kevin as a psychopath? You're having an awful time. I'm sorry. You need a better moisturizer.
We didn't bring him up religious. He found the church on his own.
How does he cope with his schoolwork?
Oh, he's a trier. Always does his best.
It's my fault. I read. It's always the mother's fault.
Oh, Carol, that's not true. Really. Things happen. Other influences come into play.
Oh,
She must be eating her heart out right now.
Alicia's very good at coping. Doesn't know the meaning of stress. I'd be rushing about like a headless chug over something or other, and she'd just sit there calmly at the centre of the storm.
Don't fuss, Mummy.
How long's she been at Leighton High?
2.5 years.
And before that?
She was at Scottsburn Girls. Jane, I appreciate your concern for her. I really think you'd be better off focusing on the other children. Annabelle's in a frightful way.
And why did she leave Scottsburn?
I don't know what you're trying to suggest. Everyone in the community looks up to Alicia. Everybody at the church loves her. She's my whole world.
Jane! You didn't tell me we had a visitor. Your mother's been singing your praises. Not telling tales, I hope.
Sorry, darling.
Kevin doing something like this so soon after the accident. You must feel awful. I don't know what I feel. I'm just so confused, you know. It's like some other person. It's not Kevin. Well, the police have got a written confession. They're pretty sure it's his. He had no idea. He didn't say anything to you.
I don't believe he killed anybody.
And why would he say he did?
I don't know. Maybe he's sick.
Do you think he could have done it for some sort of religious reasons?
Like what? I was a witness when Kevin accepted Jesus Christ as his saviour. It changed his life. He's always said that.
Alicia, I need you to think back to the accident for me. I know it's painful. Did you notice if Kevin hit his head or fell or anything while I was rescuing the others after he got you out?
I don't know. I ran back up to the road.
Why did you do that?
To try and get help, wave down a car. And the fire started and he was trying to pull Glenys out. Do you think he did hit his head? Would that explain it?
It might. It doesn't explain him dragging Glenys in the first place, though.
I had the pills loose in my pocket. I was going to do it in Ballarat, but I never got the chance. We stopped for a rest in Yay. And I dissolved a few of them in some tomato soup.
What sort of pills?
Rohi's. Rohypnol. Anyhow, Glenys said she didn't want any of that canned muck.
The soup?
I pretended like she hurt my feelings. So she drank it anyway.
When the fog cleared, she knew bloody well it had to be Kevin.
So she gave him a bell, probably the minute you dropped her home.
Suggested they get together for a chat.
Oh, she obviously didn't want to dob him in before she'd had a chance Simon, to talk
Simon,
to him.
Simon, am I telling this story or are you telling it? And Kevin knew that that was his opportunity to finish what he'd started.
How about the why?
Well, we don't know the why. I was going to go the knuckle, but Simon had the camera rolling.
Nah, look, it's not bloody funny. It's bloody tragic. Sorry, Gary.
So it's over to you, Fräulein Doctor.
Gemma? Annabelle?
We don't want to talk to you.
We're not talking to you about anything. Not Kevin, nothing. Fine, I'll talk to you, listen. Annabelle, about your father and Glenys.
Glenys was a harlot.
Did she get her hooks into anyone else? Anyone else that was spoken for? Gemma, did she seduce Kevin? Oh, come on, what's the harm in telling me? Glenys is dead and Kevin's in police custody. Has Alicia sworn you to silence?
You don't understand. We believe in a moral universe.
There are rules that have to be followed. Since when do good Christian girls condone murder?
Talk
Christ.
I've been looking for you. What are you doing here?
I made her die.
What?
I made it happen.
Toivo, you've got to stop blaming yourself every time something bad happens.
What did her dad? She's dead.
Meaning what?
She bloody toyed with my affections. Knew me in the biblical sense? And pissed me off. I was just another notch in the barrel of her gun.
Do I know any of the other notches?
Ah, hero man. I went round to Glennis's place with this pottery thing I made her, and there he was, asleep in her bed. Hundreds of cats curled up on top of him. She didn't even bother to lie about it. Jesus! Wanted him dead too. More than her.
You mean Kevin?
Kevin, shit kicker, with a spoon! I knew him before he was a hero. When he was just a shit kicker and needed his girlfriend to show him how to tie his shoelaces.
Talk about the night of the accident. Where were you when the petrol went up?
Me? Just flat on my back.
Alicia said she was up on the road.
Must have been her evil twin then.
Isn't suicide a sin in God's eyes, Kevin?
It's between me and him. I made a deal.
What were the terms?
I promised to fix things if he gave Liam back. You wrecked it. You should have left me.
Why did you want Glennis dead so badly?
Some people deserve to die.
Oh, you don't really believe
that. She deserved to die, just like me.
What did she do to you, Kevin, that you appointed yourself judge, jury and executioner?
I don't have to talk to you.
Or maybe just executioner. Did Alicia give you that ring? She showed me hers.
I won't be able to keep it when I go to prison.
When were the two of you going to get married?
When she turns 18. She's 3 months younger than me.
A white wedding?
Yeah, of course.
And what colour were you planning to wear? Well, you can't get to heaven, can't get to heaven if you screw around, if you screw around. The Lord don't allow, yes, the Lord don't allow. No traps in town, traps in town. I ain't gonna grieve my Lord no more. I ain't gonna grieve my... Jane! That's good to see you. One of the kids on the bus said that you weren't up on the road. You were down next to the station wagon when it caught fire. Who said? Where were you? I was on the road. I think... Maybe I wasn't. Everything was so confused. It was dark and I was bleeding. I was... so frightened, I guess I don't really know where I was. I'm sorry. I had to ask. The coroner's going to ask me. Oh! I almost forgot. This is for you. Well, Kevin gave it to me before he... Anyway, I think you should have it. He's Dave Gleason's CD. Why would he give it to you? Well, suicides often give away prized possessions to friends, relatives. Know people they feel close to. It's a way of saying, please understand me. I'm certainly going to try. Don't worry, we'll get to the bottom of it. I've just set the cat among the pigeons. Or should I say pigeon singular? Let's see how she reacts.
Look, there's one screwed up kid in the hospital who's put his hand up for the lot of it. Isn't that enough for you?
Alicia was pulling his strings, Gary.
Oh, where's your evidence, huh?
There's none.
Look, she's been practicing power games all her life. People do exactly what she wants without even knowing it. I've just sent her a message. From now on, she can't count on Kevin's absolute, unswerving loyalty.
You think she's manipulative?
I'm just asking you to keep an eye on her, please. I noticed you lost your pendant. I guess this would be enough to test anyone's faith.
Hey, don't you talk to me about faith. You don't know the bloody meaning of the word. Hey, I'm sorry, okay? Look, what say you come around for dinner tonight, huh? You and Ange, me and Jim.
Thanks, Gary, but tonight all I want's a bath and bed.
That was an olive branch. You rip it out of his hands and beat him over the head with it. Jane, I really don't know what's wrong with you. Just what have you got against him? Do you think he's after my money? Is that it? I know what the real problem is. I have a sex life and you can't handle it. Well, you better just get used to it.
No, I'm just sick and tired of seeing you make a complete bloody fool out of yourself.
Why am I a fool?
Trying to be something that you're not.
And what is that, pray?
Substitute mother. Fawning all over Gemma like the original doting mum.
I could have sworn that's just exactly what I'd been doing for the last 30 years. I'll be back in the morning to say goodbye.
This before, Sonny Jim.
Now. Did I scare you?
What the hell do you think you're doing?
I'm visiting you. Isn't that what friends do, pop in unexpectedly?
They don't pop out of the wardrobe. Why are you here, Alicia?
I thought I'd better tell you personally. We're not friends anymore. You're dropped. I thought you cared about me, but you've been using me, Jane.
Well, I'm sorry you feel that way.
Right from that very first night in the hospital. You were pretending you cared and all you wanted was Kevin. I saw you lusting after him. I can see it in your eyes. You disgust me.
Just like Glennis?
You're exactly the same as her. Lonely, middle-aged and desperate.
Doesn't say a lot for you if that's the type of woman Kevin prefers.
I'm not here to discuss my private business.
Then why are you here, Alicia? To punish me the way you punished Glennis? She seduced Kevin, didn't she? She took what was yours. His virginity. So you decreed that Glennis Lund had to die. And Kevin was the only one to do it. I mean, that was the only way to atone for his sin, wasn't it?
That was the price for his redemption.
Annabelle was right. You've brought evil here.
How'd it feel when you tossed the match into the petrol? It was a buzz, wasn't it? Bet you were furious with Kevin for ruining things. Was it hard to talk him into having a second go at it? But then you can be very persuasive, can't you?
You're on your own this time, Alicia. You're a sick girl.
You have what's called a narcissistic personality disorder. It means you're incapable of normal emotions like love and compassion.
I'm not listening to you.
You don't function properly. You're broken. You were born broken.
Stop it.
You can't care about anyone but yourself.
Stop it.
Not your mother, not Kevin.
I forbid you to mention his name.
It's finished, Alicia. I'm calling the police.
Godless bitch!
Alicia, put the knife down!
Afterwards, I'm gonna cut all your hair off. That's what they used to do to harlots. Did you want to say a quick prayer? Oh, that's right, you don't believe, do you?
Mum!
I came back to apologise.
Hello, Mrs. Halifax. I was just leaving. Good night.
God, Jane, what's wrong? Jane!
No polite way to say it. She's lying.
She's lying. Why would Dr. Halifax make false allegations against you?
She kind of has this weird agenda, you know. Whatever she says to you, she always means something else. I just went over there to talk to her about Kevin. I'm so confused about him, and she said she was too tired, so I was on my way home again.
Instant ability to rewrite history.
When Gary stopped me on the road,
she puts herself in the position of victim and justifies everything. She's been doing it all her life.
Why were you wearing the white cotton gloves?
I wasn't.
You weren't wearing the white cotton gloves.
What? Mum, can we go home soon, please? I'm tired.
Interview concluded at 11:32. Does everyone agree it's 11:32? Jesus.
You said some very hurtful things tonight, Jane, but I know you didn't mean it.
Good night.
Did you find Glenys's fish pendant?
Yeah, it was in the river. Why?
I said I'd come over, but then I got to thinking this was my chance to finish things once and for all, so I told her to meet me here. I hid over there.
Right, well, go over there, please. Just do exactly as you did that day.
And where was Glenys?
She came down to about there.
Like this? Okay, then what happened?
Well, I had a rock, and I came up behind her.
Okay. Well, just show us. There's your rock.
Hit me.
Now, how many times did you hit her with this rock, Kevin?
I'd know a lot.
Well, show us then.
And when did I fall down after how many blows?
Couple. Just kept hitting her until she stopped moving.
When she stopped moving, when she was dead, what'd you do then?
I went home.
You just left her there and walked away.
What's the significance of the fish you wear around your neck, Kevin?
What?
The fish. Why do you wear a fish instead of a cross?
It's like a passport, so God knows who you are. In Roman times, the Christians used the fish symbol as like a secret sign when they met in the catacombs.
And why didn't you want God to recognise Glenys?
She wasn't wearing that pendant when we discovered her body, Kevin.
Did you remove it for a reason? We found it in the river. Did you rip it off her, Kevin?
No.
Then who did?
Blessed is thee who goest on this path, for a place of rest is prepared for thee. Blessed is thee who goest on this path, for a place of rest is prepared for thee.
Blessed is thee. Ben Chabarin.
It was you, wasn't it? Why, Kevin? Alicia, what's going on?
Finish her, Kevin. Kill the bitch.
Off her pendant, Kevin. Who did?
Godless bitch.
Whoever ripped it off Glenys was sending her on a trip without her passport. She was sending her to hell, wasn't she? Say her name. Say it.
Alicia!
Mom. Mom.
That's it, that's all you got?
Yeah.
Well, you take care in that big city, huh? Here it's like Sodom and Gomorrah down there.
I will, thanks. You take care of my mum, or I'll be back.
I'll do that. See ya.
See ya.
Ma, look, I'm, sorry about the way I behaved with Gary. It was just a bit of a shock, that's all. I'm glad he makes you happy.
Don't be absurd. Men weren't designed to make women happy. But he does make me laugh.
Okay. See you, Sonny Jim.
Safe journey.
spiteful child.
You are my little angel.